Welcome to digital classes. Today we are going to learn Five Kingdom System. R.H. Whittaker, Robert Harding Whittaker, was the first to propose this Five Kingdom System. He proposed this system in year 1969. According to him, organisms are arranged in five kingdoms: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. R.H. Whittaker Five Kingdom System is based on three factors. First one is complexity of cell structure. Second one is complexity of an organism. Third one is mode of nutrition. First one, complexity of cell structure. We know that according to nucleus, there are two types cells are present. First one is prokaryotic cells. Second one is eukaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, nucleus does not have any nucleus membrane. If nucleus membrane is absent in a cell, it is called prokaryotic cell. Second one, eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell means the cell have the nucleus membrane around the nucleus. That means nucleus membrane is present in eukaryotic cells. Next one, so many organelles are absent in prokaryotic cells. Next, all organelles are present in eukaryotic cells. That's the difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells does not have nucleus membrane around the nucleus. Eukaryotic cells have the nucleus membrane around the nucleus. This is the first factor for the Five Kingdom System. Second factor, complexity of an organism's body. We know that every organism made up of cells. If organism's body made up of with one cell, single cell, the organisms are called unicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms means the organism's body have only one cell. All functions are done by the cell. If the organism's body made up of so many cells, that is called multicellular organisms. Two types of organisms are present. First one is unicellular organisms, second one is multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms means the organism's body made up of only one cell, single cell. Multicellular organisms means the organism's body made up of multicells, so many cells. That is called multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms, multicellular organisms. This is the second factor for the Five Kingdom System. Third one is mode of nutrition. We know that nutrition are two types. First one is autotrophic nutrition. Second one is heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition means the organisms make their own food. Well, they prepare their own food. For example, plants. Next, heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition means the organisms does not prepare, they do not have the ability to prepare their own food. They depend on other organisms for food. These are called heterotrophic nutritions. Nutrition types are two types, autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition means the organisms make their own food. These are called autotrophs. This nutrition, mode of nutrition, is known as autotrophic nutrition. In heterotrophic nutrition, the organisms depend on other organisms for their food. These are called heterotrophs. This mode of nutrition is known as heterotrophic nutrition. In heterotrophic nutrition also, there are three types of nutrition modes are present. First one is holozoic nutrition. in this holozoic nutrition, organisms get their food in solid form, and they will digest the food material. Second one is saprophytic. Saprophytic means the organisms depend on dead or decaying organisms for their food. In holozoic mode of nutrition, the organisms receive the solid form food in solid form and digest them. In saprophytic nutrition mode, organisms depend on dead or decaying animals or plants. This is the second one. Third one is parasitism. Parasites means organisms depend on other organisms partially or completely for their food, and also parasites damage the organism which depend on them. These three factors are the main for the five kingdoms system. R.H. Whittaker, based on these three factors, he divided organisms into five kingdoms. In five kingdom system, first kingdom is Monera. Mono means single. The name Monera name was derived from this term mono. Mono means single. In Monera, all organisms are single-celled organisms. Only one cell is present in the organisms of Monera. That means these all are unicellular organisms. And second one is all organisms of Monera are prokaryotic cells. All organisms of Monera have the prokaryotic cells. That means in the cells, the nucleus membrane was not present. The nucleus membrane was completely absent. So we can say that Monerans are prokaryotic unicellular organisms. Monerans as prokaryotic unicellular organisms. Monerans absorb nutrients outside of the body. Monerans have only one cell. That's why all functions are done by the cell. The same way nutrition also done by the cell. Next, movement. They move with the help of flagellas or cilia or hair like structures. In Monerans, reproduction also happen asexually. Especially they have only one cell. That's why one cell splitted into two cells. We know that this is called fission. Especially one cell is splitting into two. That's why we're calling this binary fission. The reproduction mode of Monerans is binary fission. Some Monerans cause diseases, and most of Monerans are very helpful to us. There are three groups are present in this kingdom. First one is RK bacteria, second one is U bacteria, third one is cyanobacteria. RK bacteria. RK means old, ancient. That means these are known as the ancient bacteria. Till today they are available in hot springs. We can found them in hot springs. Eubacteria. Second one is Eubacteria. For example, Rhizobium, Escherichia coli, and each and every bacteria we know all are come under this Eubacteria group. Third one is Cyanobacteria. These are called as blue-green bacteria. These organisms have bacterial chloroplasts, so they can prepare their own food. So we can say that these are autotrophs. The cell structure and the cell division are similar to Eubacteria. These cyanobacteria have the qualities of characters of algae, and some features are similar to bacteria. So some scientists put these cyanobacteria under the algae. Second kingdom is protista. In first kingdom Monera, we said that all organisms of Monera having unicellular cells, and they all are prokaryotic cells. That means all Monerans are single celled animals, and the nucleus is without nucleus membrane. In protista, these organisms also unicellular organisms. So that means in protista organisms have only one cell, but some organisms of protista have many cells. Next one is, these all are eukaryotic cells. That means they have the nucleus membrane around the nucleus of organism. The main difference between Monera and protista is Monerans are unicellular organisms with prokaryotic cell. Protista organisms have same unicellular organisms, but the nucleus is eukaryotic. Next, nutrition in protista. Some organisms of protista have the ability to make their own food. They get the energy from the sun, and they get nutrients, water around them. Next, their cells have organelles, some organelles present in the cell. They live in solitary, that means they live alone, or some organisms live in colonies. So many cells are gathered as a group, and they live in colonies, live either solitary or in colonies. Next, reproduction in protists. Generally, these organisms split into two. That means this is known as binary fission, as Monera. But some performs equal to sexual reproduction. For example, in paramecium, they perform conjugation. This is similar to sexual reproduction. Third kingdom is fungi. Fungi is the floral form of fungus. In Latin, fungus means mushrooms. We all are know mushrooms. Mushroom, we can see mushrooms with our naked eye. There is no need any instrument like microscope to watch the mushrooms. In Latin, we say that fungus. That's why this kingdom was named as fungi. Mushrooms are the first recognized fungus. That's why this kingdom named as fungi. Monerans are unicellular organisms. Protista also unicellular organisms, but fungus are multicellular organisms. These all are multicellular organisms, but some of fungi are unicellular organisms. For example, yeast. These cells have cell wall like bacteria. These cells also have cell wall like bacteria, but the structure of the cell wall is different from bacteria. And these cells also have so many nucleus. So many nucleus are present in these cells. That's the difference between Monera and fungi. Next, these all are heterotrophs. They cannot synthesize their own food. They all are depend upon other animals or plants for their food. Next, in some fungi are parasites. Some fungi are parasites. They cause many diseases in plants and animals, in humans also. And some fungi lives as symbionts. Symbionts means and they perform symbiosis. What is symbiosis? Any type of a close and a long-term biological interaction between two different organisms that is known as symbiosis. In symbiosis, the partners are called as symbionts. The symbiosis is useful to both of the organisms. For example, lichens. In the lichens, algae and fungi live together. They help together, help each other. Next one is, of another example is mycorrhiza. Fungus live with plant roots. This is also very helpful to each other. This is known as symbiosis. All fungi are heterotrophs. They does not have the ability to make their own food. So all are heterotrophs, and many of them parasites. They cause diseases in plants, animals, and humans also. Some are symbionts. They perform symbiosis. For example, lichens and mycorrhiza. Nutrition in fungi. Fungi get nutrients and energy by absorbing the surface they live. Naturally, they live on their food. They release enzymes to the environment. That means on the food. The enzymes will digest the food material into small parts. Then the fungus are absorbed through root-like structures of their body. They look like fine thread-like structures. With the help of these, the fungi are absorb food through the environment. Next, reproduction. Most of fungi are reproduce by spores. Spores are very small microscopic structures. When the fungi delivers the spores into environment, they are very tiny and small, so they spread all over the environment. If they put on proper surface, they will give fungus. Some other, especially yeasts. Yeasts did their reproduction by budding. Budding is the very special type of reproduction in yeasts. We know that yeasts are single-celled organisms in fungus. So these yeasts are using the budding.